Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Samer Ajawi. The Foreign Minister Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa participated in the ministerial conference to advance religious freedom held in Washington, D.C., organized by the U.S. State Department and attended by the representatives of governments and civil society organizations from around the world. In his statement, the minister affirmed that religious freedom is an integral part of the history and identity of the Kingdom of Bahrain, guaranteed by the Constitution and by the pioneering initiatives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. Sheikh Khaled referenced the Bahraini Declaration, which reflects Bahrain's experience in promoting religious freedom, in addition to the establishment of the King Hamad Global Center for Peaceful Coexistence and the inauguration of the King Hamad Chair for Interfaith Dialogue and Peaceful Coexistence at the University of Sapienza in Rome. The minister said that Bahrain represents a global model of peaceful coexistence and religious freedom, affirmed by the Bahraini society's nature, diversity, tolerance and coexistence and openness, and the respect for different societies and people. He expressed thanks and appreciation to the U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo for hosting this important conference, which brings together a number of allies and friends from around the world to work to ensure religious freedoms everywhere and to protect this fundamental human rights of all people. He stressed the need to redouble the efforts of the international community to eliminate the rhetoric of extremism, hatred, and sectarianism, and adopt a local collective stance to curb the spread of extremist ideas in media and various social networks, and to confront terrorist organizations such as Daesh, Al-Nusra, Hezbollah, and others, which threaten the region and impose their struggle to preserve religious diversity and peaceful coexistence. He also praised the efforts of the United States in combating these terrorist organizations, including the recognition of the seriousness of Hezbollah's terrorist organization and its keenness to work continuously with the allies in order to deter the party and all those who support or finance it. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, met with the senior advisor to the President of the United States, Jared Kushner, during his official visit to the U.S. During the meeting, the minister affirmed that the close friendship and strategic alliance between the Kingdom of Bahrain and the United States of America is witnessing continuous progress in various fields that include politics, security, economics, and trade cooperation in the interests of both countries and people. The minister said that such cooperation also reflects the long history of friendly relations, joint work, and coordination to move forward to a broader horizon at all levels, and commended the concrete and outstanding efforts of the United States and Kushner to promote security and peace in the region, as well as their recent efforts in organizing the Peace to Prosperity Workshop hosted by the Kingdom of Bahrain to support the economy of Palestine and achieve its aspirations for development and prosperity. In this regard, the minister affirmed Bahrain's support for the U.S. efforts, which are meant to benefit the people of the region. For his part, Mr. Kushner expressed pride in meeting the Minister of Foreign Affairs and in the strong friendly relations with Bahrain, which is characterized by the cooperation between the two countries in various fields and at all levels. Mr. Kushner praised the role and efforts of the Kingdom of Bahrain in supporting security and stability in the region and hosting the Peace to Prosperity Workshop in an important initiative to advance the efforts in spreading security and peace and achieving the aspiration of the countries and people of the region. Kushner affirmed the keenness of the United States to continue its approach in joint work with Bahrain and the countries of the region to solve their problems and eliminate the threat to its security and stability, as well as wishing Bahrain further progress and prosperity. The Minister of Electricity and Water, Dr. Abdel Hussein Mirza, made a statement in which he said that the Dur power and water plant is ready to supply the country across the summer season, and said that efforts are being made to expand its capacity by 2050. On a related note, the minister said that the ministry installed 120,000 electric meters in preparation to extend services to 400,000 consumers. An official at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs said that the Qatari state is attempting to drag its people in participating in its conspiracies after it has failed to use mercenaries to harm Bahrain. As a result of that, the official said that academic studies are being used by Qatar in order to attack Bahrain and to promote lies about the events of 2011, whereby one of the students at the University of Qatar prepared a research paper that is based on the documentary entitled As a result of that, the official said that the academic paper prepared by the University of Qatar student on the program, What is Hidden is Greater, is an attempt to attack Bahrain and harm its social fabric. The official said the rate of attempts to attack Bahrain and its people has increased, which indicates the loss of the Qatari leadership's ability to process its narrative in a rational manner. It also represents Qatar's conspiracy against Bahrain since 2011, but all of its attempts have failed. On behalf of Al-Kaabi tribe, Jum'a bin Muhammad bin Jum'a Al-Kaabi reiterated Al-Kaabi tribe's allegiance and standing behind His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa to defend the homeland's security and stability. He stressed that the lies and fabricated information recently aired by Al Jazeera television confirmed the repeated Qatari conspiracies against the Kingdom of Bahrain and its loyal people.